Hello, everybody. Welcome to Morning English. This is Leona.
Hi, guys. This is Blair. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
要说起网络用语啊，我们中国网友也算是为英语的丰富性做出了自己的贡献了。什么 you can you up 啊 ，no 做 no die， 已经在英文字典里面拥有自己的一席之地了啊。
Yes, actually, these expressions are totally Chinglish.
Right.
In Chinglish, many English sentences are strictly translated word by word according to Chinese language structure.
就
中国人有我们自己的英语啊。
Right, so actually it's not easy to be understood by native English speakers. 所以其实有些表达一些英语的母语者可能真的并不能够那么的理解了。
But many Chinglish phrases have been accepted by native English speakers,
yes.
such aslong time no see,、mm-hmm. and lose face,、mm-hmm. 像什么好久不见丢脸那这些表达已经是使用范围很广的英文了。
没错像我们刚刚提到过的、这些新兴的中式英语呢也都已经被美国在线俚语词典 Urban Dictionary 收录了。那我们今天就来聊聊这些被扶正的中式英语以及相关的表达吧。
That would be great.
So let me take you can you up as an example. It is translated from Chinglish, and it is used against people who criticize others' work, especially when the criticizer is not that much better.
那这句话呢，就用来讽刺啊，那些挑剔别人工作的人，尤其是那些可能自己本身都做不好了。
对，通常呢，还会附赠一句 no can, no BB.
Yes.
那用纯地道的英文表达呢，我们可以说Put up or shut up.、
Mm-hmm.
If you say someone should put up or shut up, you mean that they should either take action in order to do what they have been talking about or stop talking about it.、
其实意思就是要么你上、要么就闭嘴、
right.
这句话的霸气程度、和这个你行你上有的一拼了、
So
don't always lecture others.、就所以别总是对人家的事情指手画脚、
对那另一个我们刚提到的、No 做 no die、This phrase means if you don't do stupid things, they won't come back and bite you in the ass. 就是作、就有点为了引起别人的关注故意做些蠢事的感觉嘛、所以作死其实就是最后可能还给自己惹着麻烦了
Right, so don't look for trouble. 那英文当中呢有一句经典的表达Don't trouble trouble until trouble troubles you.
Right.
只要麻烦不找你，你可千万别自找麻烦。
那也有点作茧自缚的感觉啊。我们还可以用 make a rod for oneself 来表达。Rod 在这里表示呢是金条 ，bag 意思是背部啊，字面意思就是给自己的背部呢准备一根金条，就可以用来比喻作茧自缚、自找麻烦的意思啦。For example, she is making a rod for her own back by spoiling her son like that. 意思就是她那样溺爱儿子啊，其实是在自找麻烦。
就有一种什么可怜之人必有可恨之处的感觉、咎由自取啊、那这层意思呢其实我们还可以说 have it coming it means to deserve what happens to you especially something bad
对我想起来最近回归的那个守护解放西啊、
oh, yeah.
就是不看到最后我真的很有可能会相信那些罪犯们鳄鱼的眼泪
太善良
at last I know they had it coming、
就放下助人情节尊重他人命运那我们呢再来回顾一个之前的网络热词啊土豪、It is a Chinese term referring to uncouth rich people 那土豪呢其实是一个本来就有的中文词啊、But I think it has become known to many westerners 但是其实现在对于一些西方人来说呢也不陌生了
对土豪 has money but doesn't haveTaste 我们说暴发户也有类似的感觉嘛就是虽然有钱、但是呢没有有钱人的那种气质
没错那暴发户就是突然有钱嘛其实可以对应英文中的 upstart 这个词 referring to a person especially a young one who has suddenly got power or an important position and takes advantage of this in an unpleasant way
对但是呢侧重点稍有不同啊 upstart 更侧重的是年轻新贵，哎，这个意思。
嗯，
往往这些人呢还带点自命不凡的感觉。
对。
Therefore, many prefer a familiar authority figure to a young upstart.、嗯、所以很多人更喜欢熟悉的这种权威人士，而不喜欢和自命不凡的年轻新贵打交道。
嗯，那如果我们还想要表达这种一夜暴富的意思啊，还可以用这个短语 strike it rich。Wow, if I could strike it rich, I wouldn't have to work anymore. 发现我们今天教给大家的这些表达
了、right.
很多原本的中式英语啊，其实已经变成了非常地道的英文表达了，像我们说的 long time no see.
Yes, it's already an English expression used as an informal greeting by people who have not seen each other for an extended period of time.
嗯，那当然了，还有一些其他表达好久不见这个意思句子啊，比如说我们也可以说 I have not seen you for a long time, 哎，好久没见到你了，或者呢 It's been so long since I have seen you,
感觉都不如 long time no see 这么言简意赅啊。
确实是，所以如果真的有更多的中式英语被收入正式的英语呢，那大家的学习压力应该也会更小一些吧。
Great minds think alike、mm-hmm. 应该不止你一个人做这个美梦啊。
Yes.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Okay, so this is the end of today's podcast, and welcome to leave your comments in the comment area. Thank you so much for listening. This is Blair.
This is Leona. See you next time.
Bye.